Now, News 8's Weather on the 8s with meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
638, 10 of the last 12 days, we have hit that 90 mark. The only two we didn't, it was 89. But yeah, we've had 8 in a row of 90-degree heat. Well, what's the most we've ever had? Well, let's take a look at that. It went way back there. We can take a look. There it is. We can take a look. Most consecutive days, 90s or above, 17 days in a row. That was July 24th through August 9th in 1941. That's way back there. But, hey, today we'll get close. I think we may come up just a little short. But, hey, I thought we were going to be short yesterday. My son's been reminding me that we've been hitting 90 because he's working outdoors nowadays, so he's all worried about it. Anyway, consecutive days of 90, not tonight. We'll be in the 60s tomorrow. Could get up there again. That would make 10 in a row, just a week off. But I really think that, you know, the humidity is at least a little more tolerable, so it's not feeling as bad. And I don't think we're going to quite get to 90 today. 62 up in Shamokin right now, a little more comfortable there. Mifflintown just one better than that. Generally mid-60s to near 70. And the dew point temperatures are okay. They're starting to creep up, though. You notice the humidity a little more this morning, but still fairly comfortable. They're in the low to, at times, mid-60s, Carlisle, New Freedom at 63. But there's less 50s out there. Now, we did have a few showers. They have died off, just a typical ground clutter around our radar this morning. You see their showers came off the mountains and just kind of died out as they came into the valley last evening. Most of the showers the last few days, not a great week for vacation on the Outer Banks. They've been getting in and out of showers and a lot of clouds and not really nice weather. It's all along that front. That's what came in here over the weekend with those heavy thunderstorms and knocked the heat down. And this high has been kind of suppressing most of the moisture, most of the heat, and keeping us okay. Now, that high is going to continue to pretty much block that moisture in that front right on into tomorrow, but gradually it settles offshore. So the clockwise flow around the high will start to gradually increase the humidity and increase the clouds and the chance of showers as that warm front comes our way. You see more greens and oranges. They're on the dry to comfortable side of the scale. But watch what happens as we head into the weekend. You start seeing more and more of those blues starting to come up. We'll be up in those 60s to near 70 degrees, getting more humid by the time we get into the weekend. So warm today, warm and sticky tomorrow, getting more humid on Friday. Could be a thunder shower around any day, maybe a little better chance on Friday. A much better chance as we get into the weekend. I'm not saying rains all weekend, but hey, could be some showers and storms around because you get the steam, what do you get, Laura?
You get the humidity and the rain and the storms.
Steam storms.
Only been the alliteration.
It's only been 25 years, honey.
Catch me off guard, Joe.
You get raindrops.
I gave you all the right answers.
Steam, you did. Storms.
Humidity, storms.
Yeah, you gave me the right answer. You said A, B, C, and all the above.
That's me. I cover all my bases, Joe.
Smart move.
Thank you.